The bombshell book giving life to new questions about President Trump's fitness for office. And while the book is flying off the shelf, so much so that the publishing house is rushing to print more books amid a backlog of orders, legitimate questions are now being raised about the reliability of the book's narrative, how the reporting was done, the sources used or not used, and details in the book that have since proven to be false. It's difficult to ascertain, frankly, just what the truth is here, since we have two unreliable narrators. Author Michael Wolff, whose credibility as a journalist has been seriously questioned before and who has in the marketing of this book already made several questionable statements, and President Trump, whose relationship with the facts is tenuous at best. The president initially tweeted about the book, quote, "I authorized zero access to White House, actually turned the author down many times for author of phony book. I never spoke to him for book full of lies, misrepresentations, and sources that don't exist. Look at this guy's past and watch what happens to him and Sloppy Steve." Sloppy Steve, of course, is a new nickname for the president's former chief strategist, Steve Bannon, who is quoted throughout the book, making disparaging, insightful, and other remarks about various people. Now, the White House says the last time they have a record of Michael Wolff speaking with President Trump was in February 2017, just barely into President Trump's term. Wolff says he spent a cumulative 3 hours with President Trump during the campaign, the transition, and in the White House.
I interviewed him at that point. After that, we would speak. I'm sure he didn't think they were interviews. And in all fairness, he might say, I was not being interviewed.
The president's defenders are out in full force attempting to disparage both Wolff and Bannon, though not necessarily effectively. Former aide Sebastian Gorka, who was forced out of the White House in August, wrote a column in the Hill newspaper today attacking Wolff and attacking the media, including CNN. But in Gorka's purported defense of the president, he also writes, quote, "I met Michael Wolff in Reince Priebus's office where he was waiting to talk to Steve Bannon and after I had been told to also speak to him for his book," which frankly doesn't sound like an author with no access and no cooperation from the White House. It sounds like the complete opposite. But it's not as if all of Mr. Gorka's complaints about Wolff and the book are poorly founded. Wolff's reporting should be met with skepticism. The book is riddled with errors and rumors. And in his marketing of the book, Wolff made the unbelievable assertion that 100% of the president's family members and top advisors have concerns about his mental fitness for the job. 100%. That's simply not true. And consider this from CBS This Morning.
Did you speak with any members of the president's cabinet for this book?
I did not.
You did not?
I did not.
And did you speak with the vice president?
I did not.
And there's this, three errors in just this one paragraph on page 78, a misspelling of Democratic strategist Hillary Rosen's name. Wilbur Ross is identified as the labor secretary when he's actually the commerce secretary. And Wolff has reporter Mark Berman at a restaurant, which Berman says he's never been to. Now, NBC's Chuck Todd asked Wolff about these errors and why readers shouldn't be concerned about the picture it paints.
Do you regret some of these errors in there? Do you wish a second? Somebody, it feels as if you didn't get a copy edit.
I think I mixed up a Mike Berman and a Mark Berman. For that, I apologize. But the book speaks for itself. Read the book.